And as soon as we got in the car, Madonna wanted to talk about Showgirls, because we had just finished doing that. And apparently she was up for Gina Gershon's role.
Hey everybody, I'm Diane Mizzotto. Welcome to Dance Dish, where the dance ends and the dish begins. Today we're dishing about, we're gonna start off with Madonna, and I'm joined here by Lisa Ratzen, Scott Fowler.
Everybody.
And Sebastian Lacaze. So Sebastian, I understand you were part of a one-time only performance?
Back in 1995. I had the opportunity to work with Madonna on the Brit Awards, and it took place in London at the Brit Awards, so it wasn't televised in the States. There was no internet. And so even though it was like extremely exciting, it was sort of like happened in a vacuum. I was always sort of like bummed in a sense that it was like this job that no one really ever knew about. But since the internet, and subsequently like just a couple days ago was the anniversary, like 26 years ago.
Wow.
So it has
already
had like a resurgence
already
online.
26 years.
I know. It's
so that performance
crazy.
Is online?
Oh yeah, yeah. It's all over YouTube, and people tag me now on Instagram when they're posting it. So people now are aware of it. It was the only time she ever performed that song. I actually brought the costume with me. These lovely silver shoes. And actually it was, they dyed our hair blonde, so it was the first time I was ever blonde. And it was Luca, remember Luca?
Yeah,
oh, yes.
Luca Tomasini.
Luca Tomasini, and we kind of had like a history. I don't know if you guys ever, if you knew that.
No.
We were like together and then we weren't together and then
oh.
we weren't together at the time. But,
okay.
What a
but,
couple.
So it was like two ex-boyfriends. We were like twins.
I know, you guys would be like bookends if we were in casting.
That's exactly what the vibe was. We were right. supposed to be like these twins. So, and I brought these lovely pants and this lovely shirt.
And yes!
Did they let you keep it?
They did, actually.
That's so cool.
It's
yeah.
so rare.
Yeah, it is rare.
And after
dancers are always trying to steal stuff.
It's
I know
true. They never let us keep anything.
And the wardrobe people are always trying to like, did you hang it up? Where is it? Bring it to us. Let us
right.
see it.
They're on to us.
They're on to
but
us.
But after one of the rehearsals, we actually went shopping with Madonna. Like we piled in her town car. It was a very small job. It was just Luca and me and Chris, her brother, was directing it, and Amy Tinkham.
Oh, yes.
Yay.
Remember Amy? She
yeah.
choreographed it. And so we piled in her town car and went to Charivari, which was this upscale men's boutique in Manhattan. And as soon as we got in the car, Madonna wanted to talk about Showgirls, because we had just finished doing that. And apparently she was up for Gina Gershon's role. Did you know that?
I didn't know.
She
I had no
almost
idea.
Played Crystal Connors.
Really?
Wasn't that the signature step
that
from Showgirls?
Yeah, it was. Show. Yeah, bump or something. Wait, what is it?
It's a double
It's
wedding.
A double
wedding.
Right, I wasn't yeah. even in it, but I knew that.
Yeah.
So she wanted to ask you about Showgirls.
Yeah, she was like, so what was Showgirls? What happened in Showgirls? She was very interested in like how that all panned out. So we arrive at Charivari and we head into the shop, and obviously they all know that she's coming and there's nobody else in there but us. And it was just a very surreal experience to be there with Madonna in 1995, so it's that Madonna, and she's like just holding shit up to you and like, you know, like, oh, how's this look? And it was just like a crazy, crazy experience. That whole thing was crazy. And she actually was such a perfectionist before we actually did the number. They actually had to hold the doors to let the audience in because she kept wanting to run the number over and over and over again. And there was this little moment where like these kind of quiet percussions start off, and then she sings Get Unconscious. And she kept doing it over and over and over again. She was like really obsessed about like just nailing this like this opening line. And so then they announce her, and the guy goes, my flatmate, Madonna. And the crowd goes, is so loud that moment came and went, and she never, it never
it
happened.
Happen.
Like she was freaking out for no reason. But it was great to see her so vulnerable and just so wanting to be great, you know, and wanting it to go over well. It was just a great example of someone who is at the top of their game and someone who is just going to do whatever they can to give the best performance that they can.
It just made me nervous thinking about it. It's like that pressure to be like, be good and do it right. And especially with live theater, it's like you get one shot.
One more little crazy story from that job was
yes,
like Luke
yes,
and I,
please.
It was in like a big stadium. And so the dressing rooms were big trailers, kind of. And so Luca and I had our own, and Madonna had one next to us. So Luca and I were like, you know, doing our makeup and stuff. And then suddenly Madonna walks in with Elton John, and they're like—
Into your trailer.
Into our little dressing room.
That's crazy, right there.
And it was really big. So we're like sitting there doing it, and there's like a little area over here, and they did a photo shoot. Like, they just like, there was Elton John and Madonna just like doing some crazy, weird little photo shoot in the dressing room. It was just like, surreal moment on top of surreal moment on top of surreal moment. It was, yeah, an exciting
I have a similar story to the shopping in New York with Madonna, except mine took place in Nashville with Garth Brooks at the Boot Barn. It was not at Chari Bar. And it was a Dr. Pepper commercial for Jerry Evans, and it was like Jerry. Me, Sybil, Jen Strovis, and Leslie Gelbach. And they're like, oh, Garth would like to go with you to your fitting at the Boot Barn. And we're like, what? Why? And we would go in and we'd try stuff on, and we'd come out and he'd go, okay, I'm sorry to ask you this, Diane, but could you just do a little spin for me? And I'm like, oh yeah, sure. And then he'd
Suju, pirouette.
Sybil and Jen would turn around and he'd be like, And then I'd turn around and he'd go, you know, I'm not getting that heart-shaped ass.
No, he
on
did
you.
Not.
And I go back to the dressing room and I'm like, I'm Asian. I have a flat ass. I do not have a heart-shaped ass. No amount of Wrangler jeans is going to turn my ass into a heart-shaped ass.
I've never heard
and
that
we
phrase,
were
a
just
ass.
Laughing so oh hard. And it's one of those moments where you're like, Is this happening? Am I in the Boot Barn with Garth Brooks?
So
this is my job.
Yeah.
What did you end up in?
Some like Wranglers and like kind of a more of a rock and roll tee, which was more of my vibe, but it wasn't.
I think you have a heart shaped ass.
Oh, thank you, Scott.
Yes.
It's always a nice ass. I thought so.
Let's toast everybody. Yes. So to those moments in our careers where we're like, is this my life? Let's toast to
cheers
that.
To the heart-shaped
cheers
to
that, to heart-shaped yes. Asses.
Is this
and to Dance
life?
Dish.
To Dance Dish.
Dance Dish. Dance Dish.
Dance Dish. Work it is.
Dance Dish.
Dance Dish. Work it is. 5, 6, 7, 8.